maybe they've heard the term the Great Reset. Maybe they've heard Glenn talk about it here and there. Can you take give people a one-on-one on what it actually is?
Right. So at its most basic form, I believe the Great Reset has two primary components, okay? You have this massive push for big, gigantic social programs, all the things that you hear far-left people talk about all the time. There's federal jobs guarantee type stuff in there. There's, you know, the Green New Deal is obviously a part of this. There's all sorts of things called for universal social protection, which is another way of saying big government programs. Wealth redistribution, all of that stuff is in it. That's one part of it, but that's not really the most important part of it. The most important part of it is that they're going to radically transform the entire global economy and society by extension through these things called ESG standards.
Let me break that down. Let me just explain Operation Choke Point. I'm going to explain this tonight, but let me give you a little bit of it. Operation Choke Point was put in by the Obama administration in 2013. We now know this to be an absolute fact. It was for the FDIC, and I'm quoting, to freeze politically disfavored businesses out of the financial system, end quote. Okay? Choke them off. Operation Choke Point. Choke them off. So if you are quoting again, politically disfavored business, the banks would stop doing business with you. So that's what this is about. That's how they control you. And they get away with it because these are private banks doing it.
Right. This is not a government program, right? In theory. I know you're saying that's part of it, but like
partnership.
This part of it is... are private businesses who are coming up with this ESG formula, and then companies that do business that do not score well on this, you know, social credit scale, they will have no opportunity to work with big banks or any of these businesses that are in this program. Is that the way to think about this?
There's definitely, that's a big part of it, but there's also a push to try to make regulatory changes that tie ESG standards into all sorts of other things. For example, there was a very large investment group, I believe it was this past year in 2020, that was calling for the SEC to impose regulations related to ESG. And what they want to do is keep, there's a huge movement of these left-wing investors that want to keep companies that are not woke, that don't have high ESG scores, off of stock exchanges.
Yep.
And in the long run, that's absolutely a core part of this. That's an easy regulatory change to make for the SEC to say, oh, well, we're only going to have, you know, these high ESG good companies in the stock
exchange.
Right,
and this is a public movement. All of these companies are in it. I mean, you know, when you've got Exxon, and Exxon announced this week, they're part of this. When you got companies like Exxon, you would say to yourself, why would they do something that would hurt them? Why would they do something to get involved where they're changing capitalism?
And even if you were able to stop it at the SEC level, the New York Stock Exchange could just do it.
Yes.
Right. The New York Stock Exchange could just say, we only are trading with companies with these good scores because we believe in this so much. It's good for humanity.
Exactly.
Well, we're going to show you some documentation tonight from Merrill Lynch, where somebody who is working as a researcher.
That's right.
Went to their Merrill Lynch, you know, 401k page just to check things out.
Yep.
And what did he find?
He found that he had his very own special ESG score. He himself has been given an ESG score based on his investments in all three categories, the E, the S, and the G, and then he has an overall score, and it's not very good.
Yes.
He didn't do very well.
It's 4.6.
He's a degenerate.
It's 4.6. So that is like
out of
10, that's like having a 3 for your credit score. Who's going to give you any kind of loans if you have a 3 for your credit score? This is going to be more important than anything else. So, and what it's doing right now is just saying it. They're now just suggesting, hey, you should pay attention to things, the companies that are doing great things. There's no teeth to it yet. This came out in 2018. Merrill Lynch put this in.
Right.
And it's all the framework. It just needs the teeth to be turned on. And all that is right now they're saying, look, you've got a score of 4.7. That's because you're not looking at companies to see the whole stakeholder idea, where these companies have a responsibility to do good, not just for their shareholders, because that kind of capitalism is over. So every company that's being traded, we've scored with their ESG, which means those companies are required now to come up with all of this paperwork and all this bullcrap. So now the cost of overhead is enormous. Imagine what it'll be for you and your restaurant. So they have to come up with these things so then they can get a score for the stock exchange, and Merrill Lynch can say, okay, that company has an 8. Well, I want to invest in this company. It's a gun company. Ooh, they've got a ESG score of 2. Well, I don't care because I believe that's going to go up. Doesn't matter. You're not doing it for that anymore. You're not doing it to make money. You're doing it for the overall good of society. This is the end of capitalism.
That's right. And some of these ESG funds that they have, they already have ESG funds, like index funds, similar right. to, you know, these massive index funds that you have for other that we've been around forever. And they have excluded businesses related to guns and all sorts of other things sure. already from that automatically. It doesn't matter how good you could be running, you know, your gun store on solar panels.
Right.
Doesn't matter.
And
you
the idea
guns.
Is that you are, when you put teeth to this, you have a completely bogus market because you're looking at a score for how politically correct is this person or this company. If they're politically correct, the teeth tell all the lower investors, you're going to invest in these companies, not these companies, because it doesn't matter that these companies might be worth more. We think the investment should go to these companies because they're socially woke. When that happens, the stock market means nothing. Nothing. Because it is basically at the barrel of a gun. The government and the big businesses have decided who's going to get the money.
Right.
And have you noticed that when it comes to the environment, we're no longer hearing about a climate trading board, that we're no longer looking at carbon offsets and climate offsets that you can sell like a stock exchange, that you can buy and sell these carbon credits? That went away because companies were losing. Companies, giant corporations would lose lots of money on that. And who would get rich? The government. So this is a way for the government and businesses to get rich. So now we don't need the carbon offsets. Yeah. We're forcing people to funnel their money into these companies because they're going to be great for the environment. Whether they are or not doesn't matter. Funnel their money right into here because these are woke companies. So the companies win. Anyone who stood against the climate, exchange board, they're in there too.
That's
because
right.
they can make money now without buying and selling credits.
Mm. Yeah, that's exactly right. And we know this is going to happen. We know it's going to happen. The whole thing is rigged. It's all set up. We know it's going to happen because there's this group, Principles for Responsible Investment, came out of the United Nations, tied to all the things you're going to be talking about tonight on the special. And they together, if you add up all the assets that these people who have voluntarily signed on to this group to agree to invest in ESG standards, than $100 trillion in assets.
That's twice all of the money, printed money, on Earth.
More than $100 trillion. I had to check it 5 times because I thought this can't possibly be right. The UN itself says that these are the numbers. More than $100 trillion controlled by these 3,000 investors who have agreed to be part of this. And this group started in 2006 with 100 people. And so they've been building this movement. So it's a done deal. There's no way if you are part of this group with $100 trillion that you're going to put this on you're going to gamble it. Well, maybe this will work. Maybe it won't. No chance. You know how this all ends. That's the only way you bet that kind of money. This thing is completely rigged. It's a giant con.
And the only way to beat it is locally. The only way to beat it is locally. You have got to get your town out of the UN sustainable bullcrap. You need to get out of any Agenda 2030, Agenda 21, any of this stuff related to the World Economic Forum, the United Nations, and now our own country. You must be able to stand on your own. And this is one of the reasons why I keep saying you've got to protect all of your assets. I will tell you that I have not done this until last week. I called my financial advisors who are Jewish, and I said to them, I know at times you think I'm crazy, but I need you to start thinking like those who came before us in the 1930s. They knew exactly what that meant. You have to start thinking differently because there is a global system that is coming, and it's going to choke the snot out of anyone who stands against it.